In the studio now is Kordell Jackson, the owner of Jackson Guns and Ammo. Thank you for joining us. Kordell, the gun industry has been going through a rough patch lately after the Newtown school shooting closer to home here in Webster, the tragedy. And yet it seems as though the gun industry is thriving, just as I found out when I visited your store. And I'm interested to know if you expected an increase in sales like this, and how long do you think you can ride this wave?
Honestly, we didn't expect what we had. I think we've gotten to the point where our inventory has depleted so much that people are just coming in to buy anything that they can find, whether it be a handgun, accessories, ammunition, just to keep us in business, to keep us going. And I think that's what a lot of people are supporting us for.
So inventory is being depleted. When do you think that you'll start to see a decrease in volume in terms of the next 6 to 12 months as the details of this law play out?
I don't know if we're going to see necessarily a depletion of people coming into our store. I believe that people are going to still support us regardless, whether it be ammunition, because you'll always need that, some accessories, some firearms. Certain guns will still be legal. So I think that they'll still keep coming in.
When I was in your store earlier this week, a constant flow of customers for sure. Also, a constant stream of questions. People seem to be confused when they're trying to identify what's an assault weapon. Do I have one? And I want to know, are arms retailers like yourself, are you even clear on what exactly this definition means?
Honestly, we have no idea. We really don't. I've read that SAFE Act 3 or 4 times, and it's not clear enough to define or to give the consumer answers. And until we can get a clear definition of what that law means and what they're specifying, then we have to just keep going business as usual.
In terms of your current gun inventory, how many now termed assault weapons that you can identify would you say you have in stock right now?
Based on the law that was written, we would have probably a good 5 or 6 that are still left.
And what do they go for normally? What would you say a typical firearm that would assault weapon, classified assault weapon, would go for?
It runs anywhere from about $1,500 up to about $3,000.
$1,500 to $3,000. Yes. And analysts are saying that in the last 6 years, they've seen an increase in terms of assault weapon sales. And I'm wondering, did you see the same thing in your store?
Absolutely.
What is it about these weapons, and what is it that intrigues people? Why would they want to purchase one?
I think it's a cross between a few different issues here. I think a lot of people wanted these assault weapons, as they use that term, assault weapons, is because the government wants to take them from us. So they want to be the first ones to have them or keep them. The other guys are the ones that are sports shooters, the guys that go out and shoot tactical ranges or sportsmanship or anything like that. It's kind of crossed between who's actually buying for what reason. We don't really know because we don't ask.
One thing I understand when I read the New York SAFE Act a few times, as you did as well, they talked about modifications to certain firearms, and that in terms of like a 7-round magazine would be what the law states what calls for. And if a gun has more than 7 rounds, modifications could be made. And can these things be done? Like, I guess, what exactly does the modification entail? Is this something that can be done on site in the store? Is it solely something that manufacturers would take care of?
It would be very difficult for us as a gun dealer or even just a gunsmith to modify all these magazines. It's something that we haven't done before. Manufacturers, I've talked to them, and they said they're not going to do them for New York only. So we're kind of in a bit of a situation here. The law states one thing, we have manufacturers that say another, and then we got gun dealers as myself that really have no clue what we're going to do.
What type of effect do you think that modifications then will have on business?
It's going to be tough. It's going to be very tough. I believe that with the SAFE Act going into place here, the 7-round magazine capacity, it's not defined in the SAFE Act as you can have 7 rounds in a magazine or have to have a 7-round magazine. I think once that's clear, then we could kind of have an idea which direction we're going to go with it.
When you take a look at the law and you hear what's going on in the news and you're following up on this, have you been able to determine how this will impact your business 6 months down the road, even 12 months down the road?
It's hard to determine that right now. We're always going to get firearms. We're always going to have accessories. And we're always going to have ammunition. I think as long as we keep the influx of inventory in there, we'll be fine to stay open in business. It may not be as busy as it is now, but it'll always remain the same.
What's your take on the New York SAFE Act? As you've read through it, what were some of the things that stood out most to you?
I will say that some of the things that the governor was saying with regard to the gun control, having different ways of ammunition not being able to be purchased online, there were certain things about mental health. I think that's a huge issue right now. Background checks, certain things like that I agree with. And I think those should be in place as they, I mean, some of it is now, but it should be in more depth. With regard to the 7-round magazine, the assault weapons, things like that are unnecessary and uncalled for. We as good citizens, we don't commit crimes. It has no bearing on us.
When I was in your store, I talked to a gentleman who said, I'm moving. And we saw that in the story. I'm moving now. He said, I'm not going to put up with this law. I'm curious to know, first, do you think that there are other people just like him who plan to move out of state because of what this law entails?
Actually, there's a lot of people. What they're doing is actually purchasing weapons from us as a local gun shop to support us, to you know, keep us in business. I think everybody wants to see us prosper and keep the business around, because they may need accessories, they may need some ammunition or something like that, but yet they have to leave the state in order for them to enjoy the weapons that they do have. They're not going to follow the SAFE Act, and I can't really blame them to some degree. I think what he has created is a lot of civil disobedience. A lot of good people have turned bad because of this law. And what I mean by that is that they do the right thing, and now you've created these people to hide certain weapons or not to follow certain rules, and that's not how we operate. And we want to make sure everybody's up on the up and up, and you know, following the laws.
Are you surprised that people are responding to that extent in terms of packing up and moving?
Not at all, not at all. I think you could drive 3 hours away from here, Pennsylvania, and you're free. You know, it's a way to live. You're not being controlled by your government. You're not being told what you can have, what you can't have. And I think that's a lot of the problems that people are having right now, is allowing our government to control what we have if we haven't done anything.
And earlier this week, federal officials linked 45 illegal guns found in Rochester to a man in Georgia. And do you expect a black market soon to be illegal guns? Do you think that this is something that could potentially happen and the state could potentially develop?
Absolutely. I believe the black market has already started. You have a lot of people that are unclear about this law. So what they're doing is either selling guns off, finding different ways of obtaining guns, going to different states to obtain guns, and you're going to see this more and more, and it's going to become more of a problem that the state is not going to be able to handle it.
So what's next for you then?
We're just going to continue selling and keep things going for right now.
Okay, well, thank you, Kordell Jackson of Jackson Guns and Ammo. Thanks for joining us. And for full disclosure, Kordell Jackson also provides security services for WXXI.